Hello, my name is Adena Portowitz, and it is a pleasure for me to join you today as a participant in the online presidential sessions of the 34th ISME Conference for 2020. I would like to thank our President, Susan O'Neill, for inviting me to participate in these sessions, and I hope to see you soon in person, Susan. And also to thank Carrie and the ISME support team for their assistance and goodwill. Educators traditionally regarded well-functioning cognitive skills as reliable guarantees for academic achievement in school and success as adults. Today, however, we realize that cognitive skills alone are not enough and that achievement and success require additional skills as well. Such skills pertain to human feelings and how to deal with them, and to social encounters and how to maintain open channels of communication. In this context, my presentation attempts to explain what is meant by social-emotional learning, what are the problems that it addresses, and how can we successfully implement this type of education in our schools. Specifically, I will propose mediated instrumental music education as a beneficial context for fostering social-emotional skills. It is often difficult to define precisely what we are referring to when discussing social-emotional learning, and even more to connect between theoretic definitions and real-life activities. Thus, for example, while we are likely to find a wide consensus on the meaning and importance of social values, such as equity, diversity, and inclusion, in practice, we will find that these values often are neglected, and that bullying, for example, plagues many of our schools and cripples its victims. Faced with ever-growing, rapidly heterogeneous student populations, destructive behavior, and rapidly deteriorating school climates, leading educators, policymakers, and researchers joined forces in search of programs and contexts that effectively address social-emotional learning. One of the leading organizations committed to identifying skills and implementing programs dedicated to advancing social-emotional learning is CASEL, Collaboration for Academic, Social, and Emotional Learning. CASEL identified 5 key competencies to be developed in social-emotional learning. They include self-awareness, self-management, social awareness, relationship skills, and responsible decision-making. Moreover, CASEL supports programs in which the participants learn to recognize and manage their emotions, empathize with others, establish and maintain positive relationships, and make responsible decisions. The ultimate goal of these programs is to improve how students and adults interact in and out of the classrooms, and to provide children with equitable, supportive, and welcoming learning environments. A second leader in the field of social-emotional learning is ESEL, Ecological Approaches to Social-Emotional Learning. Directed by Dr. Stephanie Jones of the Harvard Graduate School of Education, ESEL addresses social-emotional learning within a broader perspective. It recognizes 3 categories of competencies: cognitive, emotional, and social, and studies them in relation to how they interconnect between themselves and with additional ecological factors, including beliefs, values, and personality, as well as age-appropriate activities, culture, and context. Many schools, communities, and districts in the United States worldwide host social-emotional learning programs. Are they successful? The good news is yes, CEL works. Research confirms that quality CEL intervention programs succeed in improving social-emotional skills, personal well-being, classroom behavior, and academic achievement, while reducing contact problems and emotional stress. With regard to music education, research confirms the particular value of group music activities for the development of social-emotional learning. This is not surprising, as we know from previous research that group music making successfully enhances personal emotional skills as well as social interactions that foster trust, empathy, solidarity, and a sense of belonging. Recognizing these positive results, we may ask ourselves, what is the rationale behind the success of these programs? What can we learn from brain research regarding interconnections between brain structure and behavior? And can we recommend a structured pedagogic approach that offers clear criteria and guidelines for successfully implementing cell programs? While the workings of our brain remain a huge mystery, scientific research from the past 20 years informs us of amazing interconnections between behavior and social-emotional skills. Most significantly, research confirms that ongoing active experiences impact on the structure of our brains. We now know that participants in cell programs who engage in pro-social behavior develop capacities for emotional regulation and social adaptation, and that these capacities produce changes in the structure and functioning of our brain. Indeed, as we practice expressing positive feelings such as patience, calmness, cooperation, and kindness, over time, these feelings become permanent characteristics of our personalities. These findings further explain why music education serves as a particularly beneficial context for social-emotional learning. While if the therapeutic value of music traditionally derived from the emotional and social roles that music plays in a person's life and society, we now can add a biological dimension to this phenomena. Most remarkable, researchers witnessed activity in non-musical brain and behavior functions while participants engaged in music activities. These observations reinforced the understanding that participation in music activities stimulates physiologically complex cognitive, affective, and sensory motor processes. As such, music's structural elements, sensory attributes, and expressive qualities engage the human brain comprehensively. And as a sensory language, music can be effectively used to train and retrain, educate and re-educate underdeveloped or injured brains. We may now ask ourselves, what are criteria for pedagogic approaches which are compatible with the objectives of social-emotional learning? I would like to recommend Ruven Feuerstein's theory of cognitive structural modification and mediated learning experiences as a powerful educational approach for the implementation of social-emotional learning. Feuerstein's theories originated after World War II as a means of helping disconnected people reconstruct their lives. Today, this approach is used to engage and promote cooperation among minority groups, alienated youth, and individuals with special needs, and is being taught in over 20 countries worldwide. Feuerstein strongly believed in the neuroplasticity of our brains and the human propensity to change and develop when nourished in supportive environments. Striving for the well-being of individuals and societies, his pedagogic approach establishes closely matched and synchronized social interactions designed to improve cooperation and communication skills. Feuerstein enumerates 12 types of information that define a mediated learning experience, of which the first three are universal and mandatory. These three universal interactions, when applied within a music classroom, foster active participation and cooperation in significant ways. One, focusing and reciprocity ensure that participants in a mediated learning context feel involved and part of a working team. Their tasks are synchronized and well understood. Such interactions occur, for example, during ongoing lessons and especially while training and rehearsing for group performances. Transmitting meaning, excitement, and relevance nurtures positive attitudes towards differentness. Such mediation occurs, for example, when approaching unfamiliar musical pieces or heritages. While working together and with the assistance of the mediator, these pieces begin to sound more meaningful and slowly gain the appreciation of all the players. And three, expanding the learning process beyond the immediate fosters imaginative and associative thinking and enables students to convey their feelings in nonverbal modes of communication. Thus, for example, music may relay personal as well as group sentiments in honor of special occasions. I would now like to show you a short video clip that demonstrates segments from mediated instrumental music education lessons for beginning string students in a newly founded conservatory. The clip dates from recent lessons during our first corona lockdown, when frontal lessons were transferred to Zoom. The teacher, Tammy Ordo, is one of our most active and accomplished instrumental music educators, who also serves as a senior lecturer in a teacher's training program that specializes in instrumental music education. In the short clip that we will now see, please note how Tommy creates a mediated learning experience in the first mediated learning experience. In the first segment, Tommy focuses the children's attention as she demonstrates how to perform a scale effective and effectively use their bows. The children respond by playing together with Tommy. In the second segment, one of the class participants leads the class, while the other children follow his example. During the lessons, the children took turns so that each child was given an opportunity to lead the class. Transferring the lead role to the children reinforced a reciprocal interaction between the teacher and the children and among the children themselves. The last segment presents a small sample of the end of the year concert performed without an audience and filmed for the parents. Tommy's choice to work on the song Somewhere Over the Rainbow enabled her to encourage the children during the COVID pandemic and to openly discuss their fears and uncertainties. By focusing on optimistic thoughts and engaging in playing and singing a beautiful melody, the children were encouraged to identify with and express their own feelings through the music. I would like to mention that one of the performers in the group, the little girl with the white headband, suffers from a severe hearing impairment and that she is assisted with hearing aids in both of her ears. Despite this handicap, and because of her love of music and strong motivation, she successfully integrated as an equal member of the group.
Thank you. Expressing her gratitude and love for Tommy, her special student sent Tommy a special musical gift for her birthday. And we'll hear that. In addition to these three universal parameters, three situational dependent parameters of mediation address the social values of equity, diversity, and inclusion. Mediation of individuation, mediation of people as changing entities, and mediation of feelings of belonging target social and emotional capacities which help people to accept themselves, respect others, and regard individuals of diverse backgrounds with empathy and tolerance. These capacities serve as prerequisites to behaving in harmony with the social values of equity, diversity, and inclusion. Acknowledging instrumental music education as a powerful context for stimulating these values, Gary Sterling, music director for at-risk children in Lambeth, London, confesses that the ensemble is where we live, learn, know each other, have arguments sometimes, and learn to compromise. It's the key to our whole program. It's at the heart of everything. Our final video clip presents a segment from a clip prepared by many of Israel's leading wind and percussion teachers for their students during the COVID lockdown. Forced into quarantine, they established the quarantine band, in which they joined forces and arranged a dynamic performance of Samuel Hazo's The Ride, which they sent to all of their students, inviting them to join them on a virtual speedy ride to many faraway places with lots of highs and lows. They hope to connect to their students' fears and loneliness and remind them that they all belonged to a national community of wind players led by their loving teachers. Social-emotional skills developed in mediated instrumental settings highlights their particular relevance for diverse, disaffected pupils, many of whom belong to minority groups and refugee families. By promoting cooperation, active participation, and pro-social behavior, mediated instrumental music education creates a structured environment in which social values such as equity, diversity, and inclusion can flourish. While the issues at hand are exceedingly complex and often overwhelming, it is our belief that by simultaneously addressing multiple inter and intra social, cognitive, and emotional needs, the structured pedagogic approach of mediated instrumental music education offers an educational context for the successful implementation of social-emotional learning in our schools. Thank you.